Hello, this is Red in April, and welcome to our AIRCRETE home build. In this video, we continue making our test sample batches, and we make a couple using different types of wire, including a ribbed wire and chicken wire, and then we make two batches using a paper fiber. For these first two batches, we'll be using wire reinforcement, two different kinds, and so here I am getting that kind of cut out and prepped, the chicken wire and then also the ribbed wire. Apparently there was a local shortage of 47-pound bags of cement, and so we had to buy the 94-pound bags and then kind of split it in half and weigh that out to make sure that was all accurate. So an extra step that we had to go through, but not too big of a problem. We're doing all of our normal prep work here, getting all the forms ready, cleaning things out. Here we have two sample boxes ready to go and all oiled up and prepped and ready for these two batches that we're going to be making with the wire reinforcement. Have my air compressor set up here. I turned up the pressure to about 100 pounds on the regulator, so that's an adjustment I made earlier on that seemed to help a little bit. I might also mention when it comes to regulating the air pressure how critical that is to the foam, so turning the pressure on the air compressor regulator up to 100 pounds helped. But it still does vary, you know, at the foam maker itself, at the little dragon, and I still have to adjust it, fine-tune it, adjust it as April is mixing, because it does drift just a few pounds in either direction as the air compressor kicks on and off, and just that couple of pounds in either direction difference makes a big difference in the density of the foam, and we found that the density of the foam is really critical, and so we have good success with batches as long as we really control that foam density. We're just using our standard batch mixture here of 5 gallons to 94 pounds Portland cement. As you can see, it may be a little bit overmixed. It's pretty stiff, so it probably was just a little bit overmixed, and I'm having to kind of work hard to get it, get the air bubbles out and get it worked into the bottom. But it worked out okay, and here I am pressing the ribbed wire down into the concrete. I was trying to get it about halfway in. Now this ribbed wire that we're using here is similar product to something that you can buy in 4x8 sheets or big rolls and put into a concrete wall. It's a product that's made to go inside of concrete, and so it's a thick wire that has kind of ribs built into it that the concrete can grab onto. So really curious to see the kind of strength that it provides. Part of our process for every batch is weighing the foam each and every time. So we take a sample with a quart measuring cup that we have, and we weigh that meticulously. We zero the scale first with the cup on it, and then shoot some foam in, and then scrape the foam off the top to get it level with the top of our cup. Try to wipe off the sides a little bit, and then measure it. And so here we got a real light foam, and I think what we had here was an air pocket at the bottom of the cup. It's easy when you're filling the cup in to get an air pocket at the bottom because this stuff is really thick, dense foam. So we tried it again and we got 93 the next time. So this is batch number 12 that we're using for the chicken wire. We used the same recipe and tried to use all the same techniques as we used on the last batch to mix this up. So I put the first bucket in the garden wall and then I started pouring it into the forms. It looks about, you know, just about identical to the last batch, which is good because we wanted them to be, you know, as identical as possible. Still pretty thick, and so still had to spend a little bit of time working that in and getting it, you know, down into the cracks and crevices and pretty smooth. So I'm going to be putting in chicken wire into this, and the actual chicken wire that we would, you know, use in our house would be a little heavier gauge chicken wire that's galvanized that they sell for like stucco. And so that's a good product that's out there, again, already pre-made and ready to go inside of concrete. And so that's another good option. It's a little heavier gauge and a little bigger hole, but I thought that, you know, this chicken wire we had here would work good for testing purposes. So I'm pressing the chicken wire in, trying to get it, you know, a couple inches down. And I'm actually going to be turning these bricks on their side to apply force to them. So when they're being tested, the wire will be kind of up and down inside the mix. It'll make more sense later, but just smoothing that off. And then we ended up putting some chairs over the fresh batches just to keep the dog off of it, keep the birds from landing on it when it's wet. And then the next morning here, it had firmed up enough that I could go ahead and put some boards on top to keep the sun and the wind off. Here you can see where the birds were landing on the concrete wall and making footprints. So we tried not to, we don't cover it until the next morning because it's just too soft until then. We ended up making kind of an emergency trip to Home Depot and Lowe's to look for concrete because we realized that the town is selling out where we live. And so we went down and bought 10 bags and we left three, but those are the last three left in town. The following day, we removed the forms from the two batches that we made the previous day with the wire reinforcement. Have to take the forms pretty much completely apart and then kind of carefully use a scraper to get in there and, you know, detach the boards. But as long as we're careful, you can handle them pretty easy by hand and they don't seem too fragile. We take them, we stack them with the others and water them twice a day. So here I am kind of removing those forms and getting ready for the next batch, which we'll be making today, which will be the fiber reinforcement. So we continue with our daily prep, kind of getting ready for these next two batches. I thought I might mention the soft water here. So we bought a water softener and have been using soft water in all these batches. And the reason we're doing that is because soft water makes more suds with kind of the same amount of soap. So it makes your soap go farther, makes the soap produce more suds. And we just thought it would be more effective as far as making a good foaming solution. And so, you know, for just a couple $100, we were able to buy an RV water softener, which should produce, you know, all the soft water we'll need for the whole project. So here we've added the standard amount of water for our mixture, and we've added the fiber to it, and we're kind of mixing it in and letting it pre-soak before we add the cement in to be mixed. This is our standard solution. It's 5 gallons of water with 4 ounces of Drexel and 1 ounce of glycerin. So making that up here, getting ready to start the batch. Got the air compressor all set up here and ready to go. It's pressurized and just about ready to start the batch. So this paper fiber that we're using is actually just blow-in insulation that we bought at Lowe's, and it looked like it's kind of a mixture of paper fiber and some material fiber and little bits of plastic and who knows what else is in there, but we thought it would be, you know, an interesting thing to try. So we put 1.5 pounds of that paper fiber product in there, and then again we pre-soaked it, and then we mixed in the concrete real good. Once we had a good slurry of that, then we started adding the foam, as you see us doing here, and just filling it up with foam to the normal half batch height. So there are a lot of different additives that you can add to AIRCRETE, and we thought about several to test them. We thought about basalt fibers, and they make like small metal fibers. There's lots of things you could do. Unfortunately, those are pretty expensive, quite expensive actually, and significantly increase the amount, you know, of each batch, the cost of each batch. So we ended up focusing on things that were low cost that we could add. And so sand was low cost, and this paper fiber was low cost. And then, of course, the metal reinforcement was pretty good too. So that's the reason we made the decisions we did on the types of reinforcements that we chose to test, is a lot of it had to do with cost effectiveness and availability. So here we are pouring this first batch in. This batch was kind of interesting. It's kind of chunky with those paper fibers, and it didn't smooth out real well. It did kind of slip right out of the bucket. You can see us pouring it in. So it's kind of slimy. It was kind of slimy and chunky. So it was an interesting mixture to say the least. So we're pouring the last of the first one in, and we're weighing out now the second batch. So for the second batch, I'd intended to go with 3 pounds, but the first batch our experience there convinced us to actually, instead of going double, we went half. So we lowered the amount of paper that we're adding to 0.75 pounds. And so that's what we did for the second batch, was tried a little less of the paper fiber. And it turned out okay. It was also kind of chunky and slimy and went into the forms a little weird, definitely kind of firm. But, you know, we smoothed it out, help from this nice doggo, and got it in there and had to work pretty hard to get it down into the corners and get it spread, you know, which doesn't bode well for, its future use, because you don't want to have to work too hard to get it down into the cracks and crevices, although we may have overmixed a little, so it's hard to tell. We'd have to, you know, try it again and mix less. I don't think the amount that we mix it will affect the strength, but it just kind of affects the consistency and the ease of which it goes into the forms. But you can see some chunks here as I'm spreading this out. You can see some places, you know, where even though we mixed it a lot, the paper fiber had still kind of clumped up and was forming chunks that made it a little hard to spread. And here we are just pouring the rest of the batch into the garden wall. So the paper fiber batches were the last of our test batches for now. We're going to let those cure and do some testing on those, and we may do some more testing test batches later. But for now, we were almost done with the garden wall, and so we wanted to finish that off. So we decided to do a full batch and try to finish off the garden wall. Also, we had one section that was pretty much empty, so there's like a 2-foot height there that we could fill up with this one batch, and we were really curious to see if filling up a 2-foot height caused any settlement or shrinkage, or see how, you know, the aircrete would do, if it would collapse with that height or not. So that was another thing we wanted to do with this full batch. It was pretty hard to mix this full batch with that mixer, and we ended up over mixing it, and you can kind of see how it settled about 4 inches in the barrel, just because we mixed it too long. We could, you know, see bubbles coming out, and anyway, we realized that next time we need to mix it a little differently. Also, our double blade mixer has come in now, so our next batch will have our double blade mixer. So really excited to see if that really helps us with the process, helps us mix it faster, and helps us prevent the overmixing. So here we are pouring that batch into our garden wall, filling up that 2-foot deep section, and just kind of topping off the rest of the wall, smoothing it out. We did have enough from that one batch to do it, so that kind of finishes up our garden wall. And then we were curious to see how that one section would hold up and how much, you know, fallen we would have. Here I am just kind of finishing off the garden wall, finishing off the top with the trowel. It does kind of sink and settle just a little bit, and then, you know, we'll also be going over it later with the rasp and putting on, you know, a plaster kind of coating, so don't have to worry too much about the finish. We did see a little bit of settlement kind of starting that night. You can see a little bit of that here. And I really think that settlement that we're seeing there was caused by not working it into the form well enough. We had chicken wire in there, and as we were pouring it in, it was kind of overmixed and too thick. And so I think we didn't get it worked in well enough, and we had some air pockets. And so that led to some pretty good settlement later on in areas, but other areas actually held up impressively well. So the next day, we were ready to remove the forms from the two paper batches. And so here I am just taking the backboard off. This board just kind of added strength and a good bottom. And then the entire bottom of the form is wrapped in plastic that's stapled on the sides. And I really think that was effective in helping these forms work as well as they did, kind of kept the moisture in. And so taking these forms apart on these paper and just really noticing that the consistency of this stuff is a lot different than the other batches. And it doesn't seem to be very strong. It seems to scratch easier. I was able to kind of scribe in the numbers a lot easier. Here we saw an air pocket that I wasn't able to, you know, work out as I was pouring it into the mold. Yeah, but this batch overall was definitely kind of wetter, heavier, and it didn't seem to be set up as well as the other products. Unfortunately, this batch with the 1.5 pounds of paper fiber, both of our samples broke pretty much as soon as we took off the mold, which we didn't have, you know, the same trouble with any other mixes. Fortunately, the next batch with the half paper, we were able to get a good sample out of that, so we'll be able to do testing on that. Making these test batches was quite the experience. So we made aircrete every day for 6 days straight and got a lot of great samples. We're really excited to go into the results of those samples. In our next video, we'll be showing destructive testing, and I've got to say, we've already found some very interesting and surprising results.
Thank you all so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You're not going to want to miss our aircrete testing.